Say good morning. We're going to get started here in just a few minutes, everyone. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. moment to share our joys and concerns. I know there are a number of names on the prayer list for our church family this week. And just to share news of a couple more names, I know that Becky had shared with me to put Tony Blackford on our prayer list. She is in the hospital with pneumonia, so we want to pray for Tony. And we want to pray for Ann Walker was telling me about Sister Sandra. So she's been in the hospital and had an AFib. And so we want to pray for Sandra J as well. In addition to all those names that are on our list, those that have been to the doctor or to the hospital, to continue to pray for those families. Of course, to pray for the Wilson family, to give thanks to our praise team, to Lynn and everyone, to Mike, for a great celebration of life here yesterday, as well as a wedding. We had a wedding for Brian and Nicole, and we wish them well in our thoughts and in our prayers too. But let me ask, what are the joys and the concerns that you would like to live this morning? Well, everybody jump at once. Y'all still sleepy after the rains, I guess. Once, twice. I see a hand in the back. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Prayers for your cousin Rebecca Pryor for an accident. Any others that you want to lift? Oh, George. Yes, sir, Ruben.
We had a rough week at work. We actually had three teachers through all separate events not with us currently in the hospital. One of them's on dialysis. One of them had an accident. The other one's getting ready for a pretty serious surgery. I'm not really allowed to share names. If you just keep our team in your prayers, it's been a rough week.
Okay. Prayers for our new Celine Tech Center, Career Technical Center team, and for three individuals that are out. Other joys or concerns that you want to live this morning. Good to see Beth and Johnny this morning. Great to see people this morning. I saw Connie B, and I don't know where she's sitting. There's Connie B right there. Lots of faces for homecoming today, and great to see everyone. You know, it's probably been a while since some of us had time for a good old-fashioned fellowship. And so after service, we want to invite you. We have lots of refreshments and things in the fellowship hall. You might want to sit out in the narthex or under the pavilion or the playground, but there's donuts and fruit and coffee and juice and all kinds of things. So we hope that you will choose to stay for a little bit this morning and to fellowship with each other. And it's our hope moving along that on first Sundays between services through the fall and the winter that we'll have a first fellowship on the first Sunday of the month. It's just the opportunity, you know, to hear about somebody's deer they might have got this week. Am I right, Joel? Can't believe you don't have any joy.
Yeah, hey, uploading season is just a week away.
You know, and I'll name one for Cooper. I had to go over yesterday to Dennis and Kelly's, and Cooper got a new puppy, so I know that's a joy in his life. And somebody brought some bear meat to Dennis. That's a joy in his life, right? When your friend brings you meat for the freezer, right? Well, lots of joys. I know that the Matthews dudes soccer teams played yesterday, and Riley has soccer today. What other things are happening in our community to lift up one another? At home, at work, at school, once, twice? Well, let us pray together. God, we give you thanks for this sacred space where we've gathered, Lord, for well over 150 years, and for the fellowship and friendship and families that gather today. God, I give you thanks for the joy of being together, of celebrating life as we remember Brother Doug, of giving thanks for a young couple in Brian and Nicole, of praying through the names, some at home, some in the hospital, of one in an accident. And in all these things, God, we give them to you. We ask for your healing mercies. We ask for your strength. We ask for your guidance. We give thanks even for the bounty of your providence that as we harvest gain in the fall. In all of these things, God, we give to you our honor and our glory and our praise to you, Lord. And together, as we gather in this place, as we live faithfully together, Lord, we seek to pray together as you teach us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Read this morning for you from the book of Hebrews in the 13th chapter. Just three verses this morning from chapter 13, verses 6, 7, and 8. And hear now the word of the Lord. So we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What can man do to me? Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you? Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen?
Amen.
The Word of God for the people of God. We give thanks to God for His Word. My word for this morning is confidence. Confidence. Been reading over the last several weeks numerous passages in the scriptures, some old and familiar, some that I maybe saw as if for the first time. Certain words were jumping out at the pages from me, and I made a list after circling several of these passages and tried to sort of put them in order for this month for worship. But in particular, I was struck by a couple of things in this passage as I had been reading the book of Hebrews in the late summer. By this phrase, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. Something that has meant a lot to me to experience, to know, and to live. Maybe especially in the last year or so, to know that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. In the first part of the passage, too, and I was really struck, I looked it up and read the passage in a couple of different translations. Back this morning, I was reading it again, and in the King James, he says, let us boast. But here in the, I think this on Bibles, the NIV, I was struck by the phrase, say it with confidence. Say it with confidence. You know, not the kind of chin down on your chest, but say it with confidence. The Lord is my helper. Amen, saints? The Lord is my helper. Confidence is an important thing in our lives. It's an important thing to have confidence and to be confident in what we're doing and where we're going. To be confident at school and at work and at home. It's especially important Christian confidence. That is the confidence of the living of our faith. You know, the Bible tells us that we should, in Hebrews, the fourth chapter, that we should approach the throne of grace, says the Word of God in the King James, boldly. Or maybe your translation might say, with confidence. What that means is that when we go to God in prayer, that we should do it confidently, knowing that God is going to hear us and to answer us. And that God is going to answer us gracefully. Amen? To approach God confidently. Not uncertain and unsure, but with confidence. To know that God will hear our hearts, our concerns, our joys, our praises, and our prayers. In Corinthians, the first chapter, the scripture says as well, well, if you're going to boast, say some translations, you may say brag, you should boast in the Lord. You ought to be telling on something good that God has done for you and with you and through you and around you and by you and near you. There should be some God sightings that we can speak about, that we can testify to in our daily lives. There are plenty of things that we can testify to that we don't like, the way they rearrange things in the grocery store all the time to try to confuse us, right? But there are some things that we can say with confidence about what God has done, is doing, and will do, because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Forever, and that's a mighty long time. In Philippians, the first chapter, the scripture says as well that we can be confident that God, who began a good work in us, will bring it to completion. You know, God is not like a teenage boy. He gets things done, you see. Right? We might get into procrastinating maybe in our adolescent years, but that's not how the Lord works. Am I right, friends? God is a doer, and the Bible tells us that we should approach boldly, that we should boast boldly, and that we should know with confidence that God is going to complete the good work in us. I like to read about history. If I had been better at reading and writing about history, I might have gotten to be a history teacher and you wouldn't have to suffer through all these horrible quizzes that I sometimes offer. But I like to read about things that happened. And in particular, I like America. Y'all fans of America? I love to read about American history and about the things that have taken place in our land. In times of trouble, I like to read about the strength of great Americans. In times of challenge, I like to read about the overcoming and confidence of great Americans. And one of those stories that I was reading about this week, that an author named Thomas C. Was writing about the 80s and about some of the lingering struggles in American business from the 70s and about the oil problem and problems in the Middle East. And I'm thinking, seems like I've heard of some of these things. And he tells a story about someone named Lee Iacocca. Do you know who that is, anybody?
Lee Iacocca.
That's right. Three lollipops for the praise team, or y'all get to be first in the donut line in a minute. That's right. Some of you young people probably don't know Lee Iacocca. If you're an old guy like me, there was a time when you'd see Lee Iacocca all the time. Maybe not at the Walmart in Fort Smith, but you'd see him. He was on the news, and people used to listen to the radio in their pickup truck. I still do. Chrysler, a car company, was in great trouble. And the truth is they were on the verge of collapse. And they had to get an enormous loan from the government, which many people didn't like. And Iacocca came into Chrysler to shake things up and attempt to turn their company around. With great confidence, he made a lot of very drastic decisions. And one of those was that he assumed responsibility. That he put his name and face on the front of everything. He went to the factories and the offices and they started thinking about how they could improve the quality of what they were doing now. He made no excuses for their past failures, mistakes, and a church word might be sins. He made no qualms about that. But he believed in and was confident in today and in tomorrow. And they turned their business around. Against the advice of advertisers and the board, he put himself on TV and on the radio to tell people, we're going to make a better car for Americans. And if you can find a better one, buy it. Now, that's a pretty boastful kind of thing to say and to do, but it turned out to be highly effective. And by 1984, there was a time when the minivan all of a sudden was the hottest thing. It became one of the greatest selling vehicles in the history of America. Some of you youngins don't know about the minivans that the rest of us, you know, used to rock them, sock them, have football games in the back of them. They were awesome. But I looked at that story just because, as I said, I was struck in some ways at looking at some of the articles by the sheer confidence of one person and the way that it changed the outlook and the effectiveness of an organization. You and I, as Christian believers, should be confident in our God. The God of our yesterday, who has gotten us here, who has brought us through every kind of trouble and snaggle, right? We sing the words of amazing grace, right? And we know about the tangles and the brambles that could have kept us, and yet they didn't. About the way that God was there in our valleys, and at the mountaintops too, and in the journey all along and everywhere in between. The way that God has answered our prayers at times for healing and strength. The way that God has made a way for our families in times of transition and job change or job loss. The way that God is present in our today, to bless us right here and right now today. To bless us in the things that we'll do, whether it's going to another soccer game or maybe taking a nap, that God will bless us today. And that God has a plan and a purpose for our tomorrow and all the way to eternity, where He has already prepared a place for each and every one of us. We can take confidence in the faithfulness of God. We can go to God confidently in prayer. We can brag and boast about the good and great things which He has done. Amen?
Amen.
And we for sure can take confidence in knowing that God is going to complete the good work which He has begun in each and every one of us. I hope that maybe this week, perhaps even this month, as we see the seasons changing, as the mums are blooming and budding, as the leaves maybe even begin to change color, and they will. I'm reminded even last night, somebody mentioned to me, you know, said, you know, you can even take two leaves from a tree and take note. They might look similar, but they're not. Each is unique, right? There isn't a leaf that falls from the tree that God hasn't made, amen? Each and every one perfect in its place, and so are you and I. Fearfully and wonderfully made with a plan and a purpose in eternity, which God is revealing to us day by day in our walk, in our talk, in our living witness to Him. God's plan is being revealed. May we bow our heads? God, I just give you thanks for this beautiful day. I thank you, God, for the rains that came to bless our fields. I thank you, Lord, for the many blessings that you have poured out upon us. We continue, Lord, to pray and seek healing for many in our midst. And God, we pray with confidence, knowing that you will meet our every need, that you will answer our every prayer. Knowing too, Lord, that you are working to complete a good work in each and in every one of us. So let us know today, Lord, with confidence that you are our helper and that there is nothing for us to be afraid of. That you are the same yesterday, today, and forever, Lord. And God, as the seasons change, as the leaves move on, help us to know and to take notice when we look out the window of our house or our deer stand, wherever it may be, through the car window on a fall day, that, Lord, as we see the changing of the earth, that, Lord, we will know everything is in your hands. And, Lord, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so with confidence, God, we pray for victory. We pray for our victory over this disease and the time of this pandemic. We pray, Lord, for the victory of the rebuilding and renewing of our country. We pray for your protection confidently over our schools and teachers and faculty and staff and students. We pray for the building up of our workforce and the job market of all of our neighbors. And God, we pray with confidence, knowing that you will answer the prayers of the faithful and the righteous. And so, Lord, we pray these things at your holy church, in your holy armor, and in your name above every, Jesus, we say. Amen, amen, and amen. In a moment, I know we will sing our song of praise, but again, I want to invite you to stop by the fellowship hall and get some refreshments, to visit and catch up with each other, one another. I know there are a number of people here today that I hardly haven't had a chance to say a word. Oh yeah, I want to have communion. Forgot about that. Let me see if I have one in my pocket. I need to borrow one. Friends, I'm sorry. I was excited and had donuts on my brain. We get to enjoy this delicious wafer first. I invite you, if you maybe pick one up on the way in, or if not, to grab one and start to maybe work at the carefully if you can at the little packet, and in a moment we'll share on the table. Thank you, Jen and Aaron, for reminding us. We remember that the Lord Jesus gathered with his disciples, that in his last days as he walked the earth, that he gathered them together, that he washed their feet, that he spoke to them even of his Father's mansion and the many dwelling places, that he promised them the coming of the Holy Spirit, and he told them not to be afraid, that he told them as well that his first commandment was that they should love one another, God and one another. And as he prepared to give himself for the sins of the world, theirs and ours, he took a loaf of bread. And he prayed the prayer, saying, "Thanks be to God, our Creator, for you alone bring rain to the earth, rain to the field, and bread to the table. You alone, Father, give fruit to the vine." And so he broke the bread and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you." He then took the cup, and he blessed it and said, "Abba, Father, you make it me to take away the sins of the world. And he offered the cup to them and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is the cup of salvation. Do this as often as you will in remembrance of me." And so it is in this simple act of worship, as we share the table of the Lord, that together with our lives and in this simple fellowship, we proclaim the mystery of faith, that Christ has died, that Christ is risen, and that Christ will come again. Holy Father, pour out your blessing upon us gathered here, men and women, boys and girls. God, bless us even as the seasons change, to know confidently, Lord, that you will never change. You are the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning of the end. You have a perfect plan for each and every one of our lives. And so, God, nourish our souls by your table and by the fellowship. Bless the food that we'll share in a moment and the time that we'll spend this morning in connecting and reconnecting and in loving our neighbors. And God, bless us, every one of us today and this week, to be a blessing in your name. We pray, Lord Jesus. Amen. Now, may the love of God, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm sorry, dude. I didn't see you coming.
Are you good? And,